They're the quiet sideline saviour of spectating winter sports and the sidekick to Friday night fast food.
But are we in for a shortage of hot chips after Cyclone Gabriel punished our potato paddocks?
Chips, specifically hot chips. Fries. It's said the French were the first to fry chunks of potato and sell them on the street. Although Belgium tries to claim the fry too, but regardless of their origins, nowadays they're Kiwi as. Synonymous with summer, crucial in the cold. But with wild weather wiping out paddocks of potatoes, could we be staring down the barrel of a shortage? And could the chips be down on hot chips?
And for more on this, we're joined by Potatoes NZ Chair Paul Olson. Good to see you, Paul. How bad has the weather been for potato crops this year?
Yeah, well, I guess you'd summarise it. It's been a mixed bag across the country. You're probably aware that the significant weather events in February and the northern parts of North Island anyway, they affected a lot of crops and in some instances probably affected them sort of at least 50 or so percent. So pretty harsh.
So given the mixed bag, is that going to lead to a shortage of chips and fries, or are we okay?
The short answer is no. It won't. You know, there won't be a shortage. We will be okay. And I think there may be a few challenges. I think distribution throughout the country has probably been pretty challenged in recent weeks. And you probably don't have to go too far to figure out the ferries we've got at the moment between the North and the South Island are a little bit temperamental. So that has affected product coming from the North or the South, vice versa.
Paul, what's the best potato for chips?
Well, a processor probably likes like a russet Burbank or something like that. Good characteristics, meet specifications well. But for me personally, it'd definitely be an Agria. It's an all-round potato and brilliant for chips. So that'd be where I'd sit. Yes.
Paul, I'd have to agree with you. In fact, I don't know why anyone makes anything other than Juicy Bennies. Put them aside. But why is anyone buying anything other than an Agria potato? Because I would say for mashing, for baking, anything, it is truly the king of potatoes.
Yeah, look, Agria, they're a great potato for probably the consumer, I'd say. As far as actually growing, storing, and that sort of thing, they can be a little bit temperamental. So from a grower base, we sort of you'd need a mixed to come across the board, if you like. So yeah.
Now, will manufacturers have to change the kind of potatoes they use for chips?
In some instances, they possibly will, but I think definitely in the next wee while, there will be potatoes and of the chosen variety. But as we progress later in the season, things may be a little bit more challenging. But it's like potato growers, and it's the same as the processors. They'd walk over hot coals to make sure that the consumers in New Zealand had potatoes on their plate at night. So
bless them. And when do you think things will start to improve?
So, I mean, like a potato crop normally takes sort of 120 to 150 days to grow from putting it in the paddock. There's new plantings at the moment, so give it another month or two, and towards the end of the year, we'll actually have new potatoes, if you like. So there'll be potatoes this week, there'll be potatoes in a month's time, and there'll be potatoes for Christmas dinner. So,
good to hear. Thank you so much, Paul. Lovely to talk to you.
Awesome. Thank you.